Kumlan a black mud, we are up to Mesechta Yuma Daf. We are up to Daf Tes Zion Amid Aleph. And we're proving, we asked a question, a contradiction about where this chamber of the sheep is, Lishchas HaTloim, whether it's on the south corner or on the north corner. And we said that Masechta Tamid and Masechta Midas have two different authors, and we're saying that Masechta Midas is actually the author of Masechta Midas, Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov. And because he's the one who said that he forgot, we're talking about in the Ezra Sisrael, he's talking about the four different chambers, he says he couldn't remember what one of the chambers were. So obviously it was him who was doing the talk. Now the Gemara is going to try to prove conclusively that Masechta Yuma actually was authored by Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov. The Masechta Mid is offered by Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov. And I'll prove it as follows. Hochinami Mistabra, with two lines above the white lines. Hochinami Mistabra, it actually makes sense. Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov, with two lines, at the Tezayin of Nala, two lines above the white lines. Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov, the author of Masechta Mid ben Yaakov, so he can't ask me a contradiction about a certain chamber, whether it's part of this. Midas and Tamid, because there's two different authors. If not, we actually learned in Midas, Kol Haksolim Shehayu Sham, all the walls, the actual walls in the Beis Hamikdash and in the courtyard, Hayu Gevoyim, were very tall. The entrances were 20 amas high, the gateways were 20 amas high, but the walls exceeded that substantially. Except Chutz Mekoyis Mizrachi, the eastern wall. So you enter the Beis Hamikdash, the courtyards, from the east side. And when you enter from the east side, the doorway is 20 amas high. But the walls all had to be low as well. Couldn't have been much higher. And why is that? Because it's mandatory that the Koyin who burns the Parah Aduma, where do you burn the Parah Aduma? Not in the Beis Hamikdash itself, but they would go to Mount Alad. And he has to, when he stands there, what happens, they shech the animal, and then he has to sprinkle the blood in the direction of the Beis Hamikdash, and it says there that he has to be able to see the Ohel Moed. So it has to be visible. And the problem is that, as we can learn, the Beis Hamikdash is built on a mountain. So even though the very first entrance is 20, the entrance is 20 amas tall, as we incrementally walk up the mountain, by the time you get to the doorway of the Beis Hamikdash itself, it, according to Rabbi Zman Yaakov, as it's proved, is above 20 amas. It's 20 and a half amas above the ground. So you couldn't, through the doorway, through the entrance, through the gateway, you wouldn't be able to see the Pesach Ohel Moed. But if the walls of the east side are all very low, so then you can just see over the walls. That's what he's saying. Now, we're going to make a calculation and show that only according to Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov, it's an issue. According to the Rabbanon, we'll see that the Heichol is only, or the Ulam is only 19 and a half amas raised from the bottom of the Harabayi. So you couldn't have seen at least a half an amma through the gateway. And the fact that we had to make sure all the walls were lower was only because we followed Elazar ben Yaakov, who says that it was 20 and a half amas above the ground level, and therefore you need a low wall. And we'll make it cheshbon as follows. So the Koyin burns the Parah Aduma, stands in Mount Alas, and Umizkavin, and he has a mind, but Roya, he has to look, Keneged Pischish Shal Heichel, he has to look at the entrance of the Heichel, Bishas, Azaz, when he sprinkles the blood, he sprinkles on the ground, but he faces that direction. Vitnan, and we learned as follows. Kol hapsochim shayisham, all the entrances that were in the Beis HaMikdash, all the gateways, Goyven Asura Esim Amma, were all 20 Ammas high, but Reichven Esim Amma, 10 Ammas wide. Vitnan, we have a picture there for you, understand? Okay, so sometimes the pictures are more confusing than the actual words. Okay, let's follow. See, we go. Time we learned. Lifni mimeno. So he walked in the first in the Beis HaMikdash in the courtyard. Before you got to the courtyard, as soon as he entered the Temple Mount, it was a soidik. It was a wooden fence. It was like a fence that was woven, a woven fence made out of wood. Like we have a mesh fence, the same thing, but made out of wood. Okay. So they have the outer wall around the entire temple. That's called, and then when you go right beyond that wall, there was this siding. What's beyond the siding? And then, so still we're on low land, on flat land. And a chel, this eser amas. Then you had like a no man's land, 10 amas. We learned a number of times about this chel. So you had a 10 amas gap from that siding till you get to the next wall. B'shteim esem mailus hoyisham. Now there were 12 steps from the chel. There were 12 steps to take you up to the ezes nashim. But how, now 12 steps. That means because you were going up the mountain. So how high were you going up the mountain? Each step went up a half amma, and the depth of the step was a half an amma. So shulcha is a depth. The depth of the step was a half an amma. So if you have 12 steps, how much was it raised? By 6 ammas. Okay. Then you continue going across the Ezes Noshim, and now you're going to the Ezes Yisrael. There was another 15 step. That's what you said, the 15 Shira Mailas. Tezvav Mailas Oilas Meteicha. And we use expression, Hayodis Ezes Yisrael Ezes Noshim. Even though we're now working our way up, but we got some normal expression going down. So 15 steps, and we're going to have the same calculation. Each step goes up by half an amma, which therefore raises it by another 7.5 ammas. So 7.5 ammas between the Ezes Noshim and the Ezes Yisrael, the 6 ammas between the Chel and Ezes Noshim. So far, you have the mountain that is raised 13.5 hours from the very opening, from the very entrance. Reim mile chatzi amma, you go up in a half an amma. B'shul chatzi amma, the depth is a half amma. Bitna, and then we learned. Bein ha'ulam, ulam is bayar, the distance between the ulam is the antechamber. In the base of Midrash, you had the ulam, the antechamber, which you didn't have any kelim. Then you had the heichel, which was we have the shulchan, the menorah, and the mizbeach hazav. And then you had the kodesh hakodesh. So this ulam, the distance between the mizbeach and the ulam was chav beis amma, was 22 amma. Ushtem esim mailus hoyusham. Right now we're learning that it's all flat land. In other words, once you got to the Ezes Yisrael, it was all flat land. There's the Yisrael, then because we know the Ezes Yisrael was 11 amas, then the Ezes Kainim, the Kain took over, was another 11 amas. And then you had the mizbeach, and then the other side of the mizbeach was a distance of 22 amas to the Hegel. It was all flat land. So we haven't gone any higher up yet. And then from to go up to the ulam ushteim esemailus hoyisham, there were 12 steps again, that is half an amma high, so 6, so 13.5 that we went up so far, plus the 6 ammas over here, the 6 ammas of steps makes it 19.5 ammas. Hoyisham reim mailu chatzi amma v'shil chatzi amma, you go up by half an amma and the depth is a half an amma. So in total you went up by how much? You went up by 19.5 amas. So according to this opinion, you don't have to have low walls on the east side. You can have very high walls, or if you raise high, because standing at Haran Mishra, you can still see, because that half an amma of the top half amma of the entrance is level with the bottom half amma of the Pesach HaMoed. It doesn't tell you what part of the Pesach HaMoed you have to see, any part, even a fraction of the HaMoed, that's good enough. However, it's not, we learned Rabbi Lezer ben Yaakov, Rabbi Lezer ben Yaakov says, it says, my lohois Hashem, there was a step between the Ezes Yisroel and the Ezes Koinim. The Gavoya Amma, it was an Amma high. This is a tall step. It was a tall than all others ever. Half an Amma high, this was raised by an Amma. The Duchen Nosso was a platform on it. The platform itself had 3 levels. So Chatzi Amma, the platform itself had 3 levels, each one with half an Amma, like bleachers. For the do their thing to sing. So according to Blessed Ben Yaakov, you will raise another amma, which makes it 20.5 ammas. So it's impossible to stand in Harazesim and see what's going on in the Heichel. So therefore, according to him, the walls had to be lowered. So when it says in Masechta Midrash Stam in the Mishnah that all the walls on the east side of the base of Midrash was lowered, obviously it was said by Blessed Ben Yaakov, which proves to us that a Stam Mishnah, Masechta Midrash, is Blessed Ben Yaakov. And that's how we reconcile the steer between Masechta Tamid and Masechta Midrash. Where exactly the list of claim is, that's how we deal with it. Says the Gemara, Amri Bishleim Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov. If Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov is the author of Masechta Tamid, then Hainu the Ichsel Epischad. We understand why the doorway was covered and why you had to lower the walls. Eli E Amri Rabbanon. If you can tell me the author of Masechta Midas is the Rabbanon, then why in the world do you have to have low walls? Ika Pal Gad Amso the Mischazel Epischad Megabed. There's the half Amma that is still space, the gap in the front gate. You have a half Amma still that overlaps the first half of Amma of the Oyo Mayid, the entrance of Oyo Mayid. Must be, because of the Yaakov, hold that there was another step. To argue about, was there another step between the Ezra Yisrael and the Ezra's cleaning? And he says there was a step, and that explains to us how the Pesach Oyo Mayid was actually 20.5 Ammas from the bottom of the entrance of the Beis HaMikdash, and therefore you couldn't see, standing in Haaretz Yisrael, you couldn't see across. Follow? If you're standing in Haaretz Yisrael and you look through the front gateway, you would not see the Pesach Oyo Mayid. Because since the gate was only 20 ammas high, the Pesach HaMoed on a mountain, remember it's in England, on a mountain, is 20.5 ammas raised from the entrance. So therefore, it's a half an amma block you wouldn't see anything. But if the walls were very low, the walls also were 20 amas high, or 20 in one amas high, you would see the top part of the fence. Remember, also 20 amas tall. Says the Gemara. Okay, so that's the answer. We give it as two different opinions. Comes along about it, but Abba, he comes along and he wants to say, who told you that this opinion is Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov? Maybe it's Rabbi Yehuda, who believed that the walls had to be lower. And it also explained that Rabbi Yehuda is the one who learned the Masechtas Midas, and he argues and different Midas, and Tamid the two offers. Remember before we had to say that Masechtas Midas was Rabbi Shimon ben HaMitzvah, and then we decided that Yuma is Rabbi HaMitzvah, and Masechtas, what do you call it, Tamid is someone else, or the Chachamim. What's this Rabbi Yehuda? Another argument altogether, where exactly was the Mizbeach positioned in the Beis HaMikdash? We take on the most opinions are that Mizbeach was towards the south. It was mainly towards the south, and it only ate up five amas. Remember, each doorway was 10 amas wide. It only ate up five amas with the width of the doorway of the Beis HaMikdash, so therefore you had five amas you could have seen. But Rabbi Yehuda learned that the Mizbeach was right in the epicenter of the courtyard, and therefore the Mizbeach, being 32 amas by 32 amas, completely blocked the entrance to the Beis HaMikdash. In other words, even if you learn there was 19 and a half amas, even if you learn that the wall down the bottom 19 and a half amas, but what did you see? There was an obstruction there. You saw the Mizbeach, and the Mizbeach was 9 amas tall. So therefore, what you saw was nothing. Remember, the Koron is made up of 10 amas. That's in the corners. The center of the Mizbeach was 9 amas tall. So you add 19 and a half plus 9 amas, it's impossible to see. So that's why he's the one who says that the wall had to be lowered at these sides so you can see from other angles. Or see it above the Mizbeach. Remember, the doorway to the Heichal was 20 amas tall. Mizbeach was 9, so 9 plus 19 and a half is 28 and a half. You can see anything above 28 and a half. You'll be able to see. Maybe it was him. So you don't have to say that Elazar ben Yaakov was that doesn't prove it. Yaakov could just as well have been a Yehuda. What's the story? Her man, Rabbi Yehuda. It's time to learn. Rabbi Yehuda says, HaMizbeach Memutze, the Mizbeach was right in the center, Ve'oimid Ve'emza Azora, stands in the middle of the courtyard. V'shloishim v'shtayim amas hoyuloi. How, what were the dimensions? The Mizbeach was 12 amas. 32 amas, sorry. 32 amas. So this is how it worked. Eser amas. Now, the Heichel itself, the doorway of the Heichel was 20, it was 10 amas wide, right? The Heichel itself was 20 amas wide. And then you had two walls. Each wall was 6 amas wide, made out of gozis, a thick. Remember the first Mishnah in Bava Basra talks about the different materials. If it's cut stone or uncut stone, the walls were gozis. Gevilah is cut stone. Gozis is uncut stone. Was 6 amas. Actually, this was 6 tefachim. But in the Beis HaMikdash, it was 6 amas wide. So you work it out. Mizbeach was 32 amas wide. Is right in the epicenter. So therefore, and the Heichel was 20. And then plus the 2 sixes on both sides of 32. So Mizbeach completely covered. The span of Mizbeach completely covered the entire Beis HaMikdash. So we're up to that design on the base on the top of the page that the author, who's the one who says that you need a low walls on the east side of the Beis HaMikdash in order to be able to see the entrance, who says Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov, who holds that there was 20 and a half amas from the bottom of the mountain to finally get to the entrance of the Heichel, and therefore they had to be able to view it by having lowering the walls. It's maybe Rabbi Yehuda who holds that the Mizbeach completely covered the entire width of the entrance to the Heichel, and that's why we need lower walls. And explain as follows. The Mizbeach was 32 amas wide, and it was centered. Esed amas keneged pisgah shel ha'em. He says over here, ho'yoloi. Esed amas, 10 amas was keneged pisgah Heichel. Remember that the Pesach of the Heichel, like all the other Pesachim, were 20 amas tall and 10 amas wide. So it covered the 10 amas completely of the Heichel. Yud alav amas tzof and yud alav dorim. Then another 22 amas, because remember, the Mizbeach was 32 amas wide. So the Mizbeach was 32 amas wide. It was 10 amas in the center and 11 on each direction, north and south. So together, 22 and 10 is 32. And what did it do? It covered the entire width of the Heichel from end to end. Because the Heichel itself was 20 amas wide. The stone walls were 6 amas wide on each side. So a total of 32. And that's what the Mizbeach covered. Yud Aleph Amel, the top and Yud Aleph Dada, the Mizbeach, 11 Amos, so to the north and 11 Amos to the south. Nimtzach Mizbeach, Mechuvin, Keneged, Heichel, Vekaisel. The Mizbeach completely covered the Heichel and its walls. So therefore, we say that Mesech the Midas is Rabbi Yehuda, and that's why we have to lower the walls. Says the Gemara, I don't accept that. Yisal Kedatzah. You, Rabbi Adam, want to say it goes according to Rabbi Yehuda, and some mitzvah is Rabbi Yehuda. So l'chayde, the east halakadat of mitzvah Rabbi Yehuda, he mizbeach be'emtza zorim mishkaches lei. There's an how do you find that the mizbeach was in the right in the middle of the azara? You mean because it says in Masechta Midas, mizbeach was right in the middle of the azara, and is that compatible with the view of Rabbi Yehuda? Because you're saying that Masechta Midas Rabbi Yehuda.
Oh, we have a problem.
What's the problem? Because what then we learn kol ha'azorah. We're going to learn now the dimensions of the base of Mikdash of the courtyard and how it and what populated. But now we learn kol ha'azorah, the entire courtyard, the length and the width as follows. Oideh, what was the length of the courtyard? Meya ushmeinim v'sheva, 187 amas long. As long means from east to west. So it was 187 amas from east to west. And the base of Mikdash was built inside and the base of Mikdash obviously was very close to the west side, and all the courtyards were on the east side. So you know, it'll soon give us a cheshbon how it was all filled up, and al roichiv how wide was the courtyard? Meya v'shloishim v'chamish, 135 amas wide. Okay, this is how it works. Now, the base of Mikdash itself was 100, the Ulam was 40, the Heichel was 40, and the Kajudasha was 20. That means the entire length of the building, the length east to west, was 100 Amos. Okay, so, now we're going to work out exactly the how do you get to 187 from east to west is Meya Ushmainim Vishiva Vishava 187, and we can make the Khajb. Malkum Dris is Ragli Yisro, the Ezas Yisro. Okay, Malkum, we're working our way from the west towards the east. The base of Mikdash ended. There was another 11 Amas behind the base of Mikdash between that and the western wall. So Mokum, this is Ragli Yisro, where the Ragli Yisro were able to step. Alabama is 11 Amos. Okay, so have that in mind, 11 Amos. Then Mokum, this is Ragli Koinim Yudav Amos. The Koinim were 11 Amos, front of the base matrix. The base matrix was 100. So you have 111. Plus you have, we'll soon see. Plus you have the Ragli Koinim is 11. Right, the Rabbi curve is 11, so that makes it 122. Mizbeach is time, and Mizbeach is a square, 32 by 32. So you have 22 plus 32 is 54. Beino Ulam, Ulam Mizbeach, between the Ulam, Mizbeach is Esen, Vishtayim. So we have like this. We have the Ezas Yisro. We're going actually from east to west. Ezas Yisro was 11. The Ezas Kain was 11. That's 22. The Mizbeach was 32. That's right, 54. The between the Mizbeach was 11 before, between the Mizbeach and the Ulam was 22. So that's already 76. 76. And then you have 11 behind the base of Midrash. We'll learn about it in a minute. It's 87. And then the base of Midrash was 100. We're not counting the Ezas Nosh now. We're talking about once you walk up those 15 steps to get to the to the base of Midrash Park. Well, the Mizbeach is Mishtayim v'Heichel Kufam 100 v'Yidal V'Am Achay Bezak Apaydes. Then they have 11 Amos between the end of the base of Midrash and the Western Wall. So that's the Chesh of 187. That part is fine. Now let's get to the north and south. Minadorim Litzofen. Let's go now from south to north. Is Meya v'Shloishim v'Chamesh v'Chamesh 135. Now how does that work? Over here, we're not gonna tell you about the gaps between the wall and the different furniture. That we will so say whatever's left over, the remnants of the cheshbon, you split between the two. So let's start from the kevish, the ramp of the mizbech and the mizbech. The ramp and the mizbech together was shishim v'shtayim. The mizbech was 32, and even though the ramp was 32, but it overlapped the yisoid and the seidim, so therefore it was a total of 62. Okay, 62. Then minamizbech utabois, there were rings on the ground where they used to hook in the animals. You have a picture there. What do you have? A bunch of lines. Okay, so here these are the rings. So you have tabois. Okay. So you have the rings, and the rings is where they hook the animals on. So the distance between the rings is 8 amas. So far we have 70 amas already. Malkum Hataboyz, how much space do these rings occupy? Esiv Abba, 24 amas. So you add 24 to the 70, and you already have 94. Then you had the tables where you did the actual shechita and all that. These tables where you laid out the animal. These tables is arba. We have two sets of rows of four, and they took up four amas. So the distance from the rings of tables was arba, was four amas. So we already have how much? We already have, 98. So we had 60, we had 70, no. We had 70 so far, then we had 94, yeah, 98. Min hashulchanus. Now we're not telling you how much space the tables have yet. 98. Min hashulchanus l'nanosim, from the tables to get to the. They had these little pegs on the ground. They used to hang up the animals. They used to strip the animals from the tables to these nanosim. Another arba is 102. Min hananosim l'koyso azora. From the nanosim to the wall azora is ches amos. That's 110. They didn't calculate. The space of the tables themselves took up. Rashi says it took up four amas. Of course, it's a little hard to understand what Rashi's saying, but someone is saying four amas. So it's 114. And then Vamoise, the leftover, Bein HaKevish, or the Koysel, then he had the leftover space. He put that between the ramp and the wall, and the place that the Nanosin themselves took up, these pegs took up. And doesn't tell you exactly what it is, but whatever it is. So between 112 and 137, is 135 is that cheshbon there. Now the now according to this calculation, the mizbeach is mainly on the south side, because from the mizbeach working your way to the north is more than half. So the isal gadatoch that midas rabbi udihi mizbeach beemtza zora mimishkachas. If you tell me that we found the cheshbon in this particular mission, the mizbeach is mainly on the south side, only part of it is in front of the entrance to the Heichel. Harubim is Be'ach B'dorukai. Majority of Be'ach is on the Dorim. Rashi makes a whole cheshbon here that actually Mizbeach does take up the entire width of the doorway, but Rashi says, but the Mizbeach, that is the base of Mizbeach. But the Mizbeach goes in. The Mizbeach goes in. And if it's Rabbi Yehuda, you're saying that the problem is that the Mizbeach is blocking. The Mizbeach, as it goes in, you can see on the side, because the Yisayid right away goes in and Amo. So you should be able to see a little bit. And therefore, it cannot be Rabbi Yehuda. Harubun the Mizbeach B'dorim Koi, and we'll have Shmamino Rabbi Lezer ben Yaakov, must be that it's Rabbi Lezer ben Yaakov Shmamino. Your answer that the author of Masechtim is Rabbi Yehuda can't be, because Rabbi Yehuda holds that the Mizbeach was mamish in the dead center and took up the entire width of the building. And according to the calculation in this Mishnah in Midas, it is not dead center, it's towards the south. So it can't be that the author is Rabbi Yehuda. It must be the author of Rabbi Lezer ben Yaakov. We go back to the answer we gave before. Rabbi Lezer ben Yaakov made a whole calculation. If you added that extra step between Ezra's Kainim and Ezra's Yisrael, it raised the base of Migdash, the Ulam, by 20 and a half amas. And since the very first gateway is only 20 amas tall, standing in Haraz Esim, looking through that gateway, you won't be able to see the Pesach HaYomer. Any part doesn't make a difference. The Torah just says Pesach HaYomer. You can see the top. When we say now that the walls are lowered, you're not seeing the bottom, you're seeing the higher end of the passive. That's good enough.
Starts.
Yeah, I can see it. You're standing straight across, level across. You see straight across in the entrance, you see straight across. Yeah.
This is the entrance, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the bottom. For sure you can't see. If the walls on the east side were very, very tall, if the walls on the east side are very, very tall, and the walls are, this is the entrance, but the
This is the
gateway right here. You have a thing, and you're climbing up the mountain, and by the time you get to the Pesach Eil Moed, it's right over here. See, so when you're looking through the cup on the bottom, how do you see what's above this line here? Your eye level can only see straight, right across, and you're looking straight across, level. Your eye is level, you're seeing straight across, horizontal. You're not standing on the ground, on a level ground that you can look upwards. You're on a mountain, the same level, the same height as here. So you're looking straight across horizontally. If you're looking horizontally, you're gonna see right here, a half an hour below. So you won't see anything above that half amal. You can only see, you'll see 20 amal. You cannot see anything above the half amal. Do you follow?
Why can't I see up?
Because you're standing on the same level. How can you see up? You're across, right? You're standing on Zayim, you can actually see how close you are. But you're standing on a har, just as well. And you're looking straight across. if you'd be on the ground, you're looking upwards. So you would see through the gate and you would look upwards on an angle so you'd be able to see, you know, the heichal. Yep, see through at Pesach HaMoed. And you're looking straight across horizontally, and your eye level is right here. But if the walls are lower, then you're just looking over the walls.
Right.
And then you can see the top part of the entrance. Good enough. Okay? So, now the Gemara attempts on a third answer. Rav Ada, we're not going to learn to, you're supposed to learn the answer, and the Raya he'll bring, we'll learn tomorrow. Rav Ada, Berei, Rav Ada, says, Hai Lishcha, let's go back to the original question. Your question was that in the Machlek, there's a stira between Mesechta Tamid and Mesechta, what do you call it? And Mesechta Midas, because he said that in Mesechta Midas, it says that the Lishchas Hatloim was in the southwest corner. When there it says it was on the northeast corner, right? You had a stira. So you try to say it's two different opinions. That was one answer. Blazman Yaakov, different Tanoim. He says it's not different Tanoim. It was located in such a place that it depends which direction you're looking from. If you're all the way in the north, it looks like it's on the south side. But if you're all the way in the south and you're looking at it, it looks like it's on the north side. It sort of straddles the center. And yeah, so Gemara says, this chamber of Tloyin where they kept the sheep, you know, 4 days you have to mevake the sheep, make sure there's no movement. What happened is that it sort of straddles both corners. It's quite long. So therefore, it's on the west side. And it goes towards the north and it goes towards the south. So therefore, with the osim itself, and if you're looking at, you're standing on the north side and you're looking towards this lishchazatloi mischazir lebedarim, you get this image that it's actually on the south. But with the osim bedarim, if you're coming from the south side and you're looking to this room, this elongated room, mischazir lebedarim, it looks like it's a north. And therefore, that's why it's not a machlekes. One Mishnah is looking at it from the south side, and one Mishnah is looking at it from the north side. And then the Gemara is going to bring us a proof. We'll learn tomorrow already the proof. But actually, that's where the room was located. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow, Mitzvah Shem.